So right now we're at about 145 vaccines that are in development, about 21 are in clinical trials. But typically vaccines take several years to research and develop. Like I think the mumps vaccine took about 3 to 4 years. And so this idea of developing a vaccine within less than a year's time or by the end of 2020 is quite ambitious. There are tons of ethical issues when it comes to vaccines. I mean, even starting from the research and development phase. So some of the research is done on cell lines that are actually fetal cell lines. So they're from fetuses, right? And so, you know, definitely there are a number of Catholic organizations that have come forward and expressed concern about this. And there may be some, you know, Americans that don't want to take it, the vaccine, if it's derived from a fetal cell line. Then also, we know that HeLa cells, which are cells derived from a Black woman who lived in poverty named Henrietta Lacks, her cells were taken from her without her informed consent. And companies have made millions, if not billions of dollars off those cells. And so we know that some of the research and development are also using HeLa cells as well. And then even moving into who is going to get the vaccine first, there are ethical issues there, right? So how are you going to prioritize who should get the vaccine first versus who's going to be the last person to get it? When President Trump came out with the Operation Warp Speed, there was some discussion about, you know, who would receive priority. But I think that, you know, the general consensus is that healthcare workers will definitely receive first priority, as well as nursing home residents and people who are in these sort of these congregate settings. And then probably after that, people who are essential workers or first responders like firefighters and police officers. And then probably the third group will probably eventually be the general public. The administration has specifically mentioned that they will make the vaccine available to vulnerable populations, including populations who aren't able to afford to pay for it out of pocket. But I think in thinking about these public-private partnerships that a lot of these vaccines are coming out of, I think many of them have made promises about ensuring that vulnerable populations receive the vaccine. Now, we'll see what happens, especially with billionaires, because we saw what happened with testing, that a lot of people that were affluent or politicians were able to get access to testing very early when many other Americans could not.